There are a lot of factors that cause the disparities. So it's interesting that worldwide, there's not necessarily a distinction or a difference. There is something special about being in the United States. There are, you know, the stress of racism is definitely a factor. We also know there's some genetic factors with African Americans that we tend to be more salt sensitive, which can then lead to high blood pressure. There are also just some other factors. Being obese or being overweight increases the risk of high blood pressure, and unfortunately African Americans have higher rates of being overweight. There's some genetic factors, there's some social factors that lead to, unfortunately, higher rates of high blood pressure in African Americans. African Americans, like everyone, should get regular screenings, you know, of their blood pressure. So being seen by a primary care physician on a regular basis will be helpful. Knowing your family history is important. I know I come from a family where pretty much everybody has high blood pressure, and it was just going to be a question of when was it going to hit. Trying to exercise on a regular basis will definitely help in trying to prevent the onset of high blood pressure. Maintaining a healthy body weight is another way that you can maybe stave off the onset of high blood pressure. And then dietary habits. So following a diet that is low in fat, that's high in fresh fruits, vegetables, whole grains, is going to put you on a track to maybe prevent the onset of high blood pressure. And then being physically active, so shooting for, say, 150 minutes of moderate exercise per week, or trying to shoot for maybe 10,000 steps a day, can definitely decrease the risk of developing hypertension.